Hey class 5, in today's video we will do the book exercise of lesson 5, Teddy Pen's Flying Adventure. So let us see how many of them we have. Okay, we will start from here. Children, I will also post the question answers of this chapter in my next video. You can find the link in the description box for that. And remember to like the video and subscribe. So here we have first of the A match the column is given to us and I had matched them for you. These can be according to the character they played in this story, their qualities. So crow is kind and generous. King Eagle, practical. Terrapin, not content. Vulture, mischievous. Hawk, sensible. Okay, now turning to the next exercise we have. Okay, it is based on the synonyms. Okay, so what are synonyms first? Synonyms are the word that had a similar meaning. Suppose we can say two words that have a same meaning, we can say just like happy, delight. No, though both the meanings are same, happy, delight. Okay, now annoyed is the word given to us. Annoyed ka matlab hota hai kisi se naraaz hona, pareshan hona. So annoyed, we have to find out the synonym. So I have found irritated, similar to annoyed. Displeased matlab kisi se khush nahi hona. Annoyed is again here because we have given this word same over here. Irritated, displeased, annoyed. Glide, slither, wriggle, glide. Delicate, soft, tender, delicate. Jump, swoop, leap. Leap means to jump higher. Okay, now then we have some of the riddles are given. Children, these are the tongue twisters. You can speak them. And then why we speak the tongue twisters? To make it a habit of speaking a language. Okay, so that our tongue would be twist and we can be able to pronounce more words more clearly. Now moving to the next one, and that is a dictionary skill. You have to just find out the meaning of the words given to you, and they are delight matlab khush hona, great pleasure, joy. Great pleasure, we can speak pleasure, joy. Gliding, to move easily without stopping. Horrible, bad, unpleasant. Nervously, easily frightened. Scared, frightened. Tender, kind and loving. Okay, next we have auxiliary verbs are given. And what are auxiliary verbs? Auxiliary verbs are the, just like we can say the words is, am, are, was, were, and some modals like can, could, may, might, should, such like that. These are all called the auxiliary verbs. Now turning to the next page, and that's page 50 of your English channel book, class 5. Okay, here we have to just fill the correct auxiliary verb from the brackets. They are given to us. It's very easy actually. Okay. Helping verbs and auxiliary verbs are the verbs that help main verb flying and fly. Such verbs are called helping verb. Complete the sentence using auxiliaries. So were and was given to us. The boys, as it is plural, so we use were. If a boy is there, singular is there, na, then we use are. Next, have. They read Alice in Wonderland. Alice in Wonderland is a famous book, a story book. Okay, then we have plural, they is there, na, so I've written have. Now, she will tell a story. Okay, was, it denotes past tense, but will, future tense, so she will tell. अगर यहाँ पे told होता तो हम थोड़ा सा वो ing telling just like this होता तो हम was लिखते, but will is there. All the children, okay, all the children, again plural is there, are going to play football. We cannot use is at this place. My friends have bought a bucket of flowers. Have, are, because it's a, my friends have bought. Now here we have the third form of the verb bring is there. So we always use has, have or had before the third form of the verb in a sentence. Remember that. So that's why I have used are, have. Are we cannot use it because are comes with the continuous tenses. Now, dash, you know the way to the zoo. Now, have you way? Okay, because it is a question and it's a simple present tense. And verb is also in the its base form. Verb, what is the verb here? Yeah? No. No is the verb. It's also in the base form. So, I have written do. Next exercise, we have forms of verb past and past participle. Write the past form of these. Okay, children, you can zoom that, take a screenshot and finish your work. Now, write the past forms of these verbs. Now, just see, some of the verbs are just made in the second form, past tense form, by adding just ed to them. Just call, called, play, played, watch, watched, sip, sipped. Next, feel. Now, some are the irregular verb. They can be, their second form would be different from, we cannot make it just like adding just ed. No? Feel, felt, buy, bought, ride, rode, take, took. Okay, just see, here we have some of the three forms are given to us. Just see this. These are the three forms of verb. It's first form, second form, third form. Okay, first form होती है base form, जिसमें हम verb की बिल्कुल first form, base form आती है. इसमें हम जब s लगा देते हैं तो वो भी present tense ही होता है. Simple past is the second form of the word. It denotes that action has been done in the past. Past participle, it means the action has been finished. So drive, gaadi chalana, drove, gaadi chalai thi. And driven, gaadi chala chuke. Grow, grew, grown. Go, went, gone. Speak, spoke, spoken. Fall, fell, fallen. Cut, cut, cut. Next we have feel, felt, felt. Drink, drank, drunk. A is here and here you. Ride, rode, ridden. See, saw, seen. Freeze, froze, frozen. Put, put, put. Okay, children, you have to speak with me and just try to speak them. You have to speak them 5 times so that you can learn them. And have fun while reading. Okay, now we'll do the past participle. Now, what is the past participle? Past participle is the third form which we called. Simple past form, past participle form. Now, it's past participle form. Draw, dropped. Find, found. Strike, struck or striken. We can use both. Break, broken. Second form broke hoti hai, third form broken. Brush, brushed. Steal, stolen. Eat, eaten. Second form hoti ate, A-T-E. Eat, ate, eaten. ठीक है, ये third form है, eaten. Hit, hit, hit. Three forms are same. Similarly, children, I just want to tell you that in the verb read, is the thing? Read. First form is also read. Second form, read. It's the second form. Third form, read. The spelling would be same. But in the first form, we can say read. Read. Second form, read. Third form, read. Read, read, read. But spelling would be same. Only the pronunciation is different. Okay, remember that thing? Now we are moving to the next exercise. And that's, we have models. Okay, shall we revise? Because I have taught you in the class 4 also. Okay, models. Here, yeah, helping verbs like can, could, may, might, must, shall, should, will, would be also known as models verb or models. Now, uses will and could. Both you can use just to request for something, but could would be more polite than that. Will you open the door for me, please? Yeah, could you open the door for me? Now, to ask for the permission, can, could, may. Three things you can use. Formally, we'll just use may, but could would be more polite than can. So, can we watch television now? May we watch television now? Can, okay, similarly in this way. So, turning to the next page, it's page 52. To show possibility. May and might is used to show possibility. It may rain. It might be rain. If we have remote possibilities there, we just say might. To show ability. Ability means I can do it. I can run. I can fast. I can dance. Whatever it is. So, can shows us ability. And could shows us past ability. To show determination. Will. Will. I will do it. I will definitely do it. I will make it. So, I will is used with a determination. जब हमें दृढ़ निश्चय कर लेते हैं, तब हम will use करते हैं. To make an offer or suggestion. Suggestion करना है, किसी को offer देना है किसी चीज़ का, तो हम can, could use करते हैं in spoken language. To give permission, to tell someone that something is allowed. Allowed. You use may and can. कुछ allow करना है, तो उसके लिए हम may और can use करते हैं. Now, turning to the next exercise we have. Underline the morals in these sentences, right? Where? Write the purpose. We have to just write the purpose. Could you pass me the salt, please? It's a request. It is done for you. You may board the train now. It's a possibility and it can be a suggestion also. Okay. You can also write possibility, suggestion. Remember. We might need your help tomorrow. It's a remote possibility. No? May I get a ticket for Piccadilly, please? Ask for. Kuch pooch raha hai na? Kuch mang raha hai. I will take Timmy for a walk every evening. It shows determination. No, I will take. I will do it. Can you see the view from there? It's ability. Would you like to work on Sundays? It's again a request. Question also. Can I help you with anything? It's also an ability that I can help you. Okay, children, it's your exercise. Next, you have the exercise, message writing. Message writing, I think you can all know very well how we will write a message. Already gone through with all the messages, WhatsApp, we are using it continuously. Okay, a message is an introduction. Message is a short note that conveys most important information to somebody. It should be written in the simple language. Now, what you have to do, the question is, imagine that you are terrapin. King Eagle has taken you for far away from home. Hawk will take a message to your family. Write a message telling them, where are you, what had happened, when you will be back. How are you feeling? So, remember, message should be very short. So, here we have. Okay, first we have to write the day. It's Friday, I have written already. Date, 14th August, is today's date. Whenever you write that day's date. Okay, time is there. Father, okay, hum father ko message kar rahe hain. And I am Terrapin. It is to inform you that King Eagle has taken me far away from home. Bahut dur le gaya King Eagle. As I always grumble that I couldn't fly, I was so scared and shuddered. Shuddered means be frightened, very frightened. And shuddered at the thought, if I fell down, I am happier and safer at ground now. I know it. Now he never grumbles. Okay? So this is the message. You can zoom it, write it down. Have a nice day. And remember to like and subscribe to the channel.